You want to roll over your 401k to a Roth IRA. This can be a simple process, but there are major mistakes that could cost you a fortune. If you value your hard-earned money, be sure to watch this entire video, or you could hand the IRS a fat check. For those who don't know me, I'm Eric Powell with The Future Mill. So I'm guessing you have a 401k you would like to roll into a Roth IRA. There are so many concerns with doing this. I've even heard of advisors making these mistakes, whether it be because they don't care how much you pay in taxes or because they're just ignorant in how it all works. So let's get you educated. To start with, if you have a 401k that is Roth, it is pretty straightforward. Open a Roth IRA, complete the 401k company paperwork to do the rollover, and you're done. The issue is, about everyone I have helped with this process has both pre-tax 401k contributions and some also have Roth after-tax contributions. To handle an account that has both pre-tax and after-tax, the cleanest way to do it is to open a traditional IRA to roll the pre-tax money and a Roth IRA to roll after-tax money. This allows you to keep the rollovers clean by keeping the pre-tax and after-tax money separate. If you really want it all in the Roth and your old employer plan allows it, you can transfer the pre-tax directly to the Roth, but you will then owe taxes on the entire amount. This is one of the biggest mistakes that I see. Here's why. If you roll your pre-tax 401k into a Roth, whether it be you or your advisor helping you, tax brackets must be looked at and the overall impact of taxes. A tax and or a financial plan should be utilized to view the tax burden both now and in the future and create a strategy that is best based on today's tax laws. And when I say financial plan, I don't mean a DIY, plug in the numbers, see when to retire plan. This type of plan is generally built by a financial planner. Nobody can predict what taxes will be, but you can limit the amount of taxes you pay if you convert your old 401k money to Roth over a period of time instead of doing it all at once. Another area of concern I have seen is that some people like to take the money out of their 401k, get a check, then deposit that money into an IRA prior to converting the funds. Be careful if you do this, because you only have 60 days to deposit money from an old employer plan into another retirement account. After 60 days, this money is considered to be withdrawn and you will pay tax on the entire balance plus a 10% penalty for an early withdrawal if you're under age 59 and a half. But wait, there's more. Also, if you've watched this far, please hit the like button so YouTube will show others this video. The next concern you must look out for is the five-year rule. A conversion to a Roth IRA from a pre-tax employer plan or a traditional IRA has a five-year period that the money converted must stay in the account. This is commonly misunderstood because people think that they can open a Roth IRA and 5 years later, they're good to withdraw. That is not correct. This five-year period is a separate period for each conversion and rollover. I put the link to the information below that takes you to the IRS site and explains this, but this is the type of stuff that so many people get wrong, and I do not want you to make these mistakes. Another mistake, which is probably one of the biggest that I see, is if you plan to roll your 401k into a traditional IRA and then convert the money over time to a Roth IRA. It's a great strategy, but there's one caveat that many people miss. If you have after-tax IRA contributions in a traditional IRA and you convert money to a Roth IRA, you are now subject to the pro rata rule. I'm sure you're sick of these rules because I know I am, but you must remember, if you are going to play the game, you have to know how to do it correctly, or instead, they will play the game against you. The pro rata rule is another video for another day, though I will give you the basics now. When you have after-tax contributions to a traditional IRA, and you mix those with a 401k that you rolled over, and you plan to convert it, you must convert the entire balance over time, or your withdrawals from your Roth will not all be tax-free, and instead, they will be based on a calculation the IRS has put in place. I know this is a lot of information. If you're looking for a fiduciary financial advisor to guide you, go to thefuturemill.com, select your membership, or book a call. We'd be happy to have a conversation. Thank you for watching.